The Minister of State for Finance, Henry Musasizi, led officials of Uganda Revenue Authority to the Parliamentary Committee of Finance to present the budget estimate of the tax collectors.
In this financial year 2023-24, URA is projected to collect 29,672 billion, which is an increase of 4,520.43 billion from last financial year 2022-23, target of 25,151.57 billion. In the period,
according to the Commissioner General of URA, John Rujochi Musingzi, the entity surpassed its revenue collection target in the last financial year 2022-2023 by 57.48 billion shillings, indicating 100.23% performance.
Collections as at the end of December last calendar year was 13.137 trillion. Against the target of 13.937 trillion. This resulted in a performance of 94.25% and the shortfall of 801 billion.
URA announced 515 billion shillings collected from tax arrears following the waiver of interest that was given to tax defaulters if they pay their outstanding principal tax by December 31, 2023. URA beseeched Parliament to consider extension of this waiver given its good performance that has boosted recoveries.
Request that will be following on kind consideration of Parliament to extend the period, because indeed many taxpayers were unable to take advantage of 40D waiver for a number of reasons.
That kind of freedom of not putting accrued penalties on the taxes has made business community to comply.
URA has been allocated 619.989 billion shillings in the 2024-2025 financial year, of which 253.495 billion shillings will go towards payments of wages, 321.174 billion shillings for non-wage expenditure, while 45.320 billion shillings will cover development expenditure. But the entity seeks an additional 167 billion shillings to recruit 1,278 new staff in order to improve the efficiency of the authority.
Under this, Honorable Chair and Members, the Uganda Revenue Authority is doing a structural review, one, to improve efficiency of the organization, to add on to the number of foot soldiers required to do this noble mandate, to plug some of the revenue leakages, and this activity had not happened for quite a long period of time. So we are doing this and it's about to be completed, but we already have the numbers.
We have seen the financial implication, but we are ready to take that trajectory as long as we plan with you to make sure we are self-sufficient.
If you can collect 29 trillion by June, it means that with just a modicum of 10% growth, you should be able to hit 32.
Meanwhile, Parliament's Trade Committee has declined to scrutinize the 2024-2025 budget for the Ministry of Trade, Industry and Cooperatives until the Ministry implements the directive to have Geraldine Sully relieved of her duties as accounting officer, as had earlier been recommended by Parliament. The pronouncement was made by Mwine Mpaka, Chairperson Trade Committee, during a meeting held between the MPs and the Ministry of Trade to scrutinize the budget, but the meeting was aborted after the two sides failed to agree.
As long as the accounting officer is still Madame Geraldine Sully, the Trade Committee has unanimously agreed not to appropriate money. If government wishes her to remain as a permanent secretary, we have no issue. But for someone to remain accounting officer, for us to give this same person we have cited in the past incapable of managing government resources, and we again appropriate these resources to her,
Committee members argued that Parliament has a number of unresolved matters surrounding lack of accountability for the money allocated to the ministry, as well as issues with the accounting officer of the Ministry of Trade, wondering why the committee should go ahead and issue the entire budget to the same officer to manage.
Ministers, go and face the person who ordered. Tell him that the Parliament has said ABCD. We are also ready to face him. Because this is something which you should not joke with.
It seems the ministry is also strained somewhere. You have given an order, remove the accounting officer, and the Minister of Finance removes, but another order comes and says, this must be reversed. In this sense, put yourself in our shoes. What do we do? Do we put the minister at the halt? Do we continue? So the powers belong to this committee.
However, Minister of Trade and Industry, Francis Mwebesa, disagreed with the sentiments of the committee, saying that everything that was requested for by the committee was implemented. However, the ministry's actions were overturned by a letter from the President Museveni halting the sacking of Sally.
Chairman, but somebody said we are members of parliament as well, as you said. We are on the side, what you are saying. But we happen to be the executive.
You also, your hands are tied, so let us assist you.
Sally dragged Parliament to court for a judicial review of the Trade Committee report, accusing it of bias and witch hunt. She also accused the committee of exceeding its mandate. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.